You may wonder, what do bicycles and art have in common? Well, it turns out a lot more than we may initially think. Museums across the country are merging these two worlds together to highlight bike culture in our society. And a new exhibit opening in Rochester this week is going a step further. Joining me now to discuss Ride It, Art and Bicycles in Rochester at the Rochester Contemporary Art Center, also called RoCo, is Bleu Cease, Executive Director and Curator at RoCo, Dr. Scott MacCrae with the Rochester Cycling Alliance, and local artist Cordell Cordaro. And it's great to have all of you here.
Thank you for having us.
I know people are, you know, they might not think about art and bicycles coming together, and they might think this is an interesting idea for an exhibit. And it was when I was doing my research before this interview, I found articles about different museums really merging these two together to look at bike culture and to look at bicycles as objects of design. So talk to me a little bit about Bleu, how this exhibit is encompassing that and even going a step further.
Well, there's really this long history of artists engaging with the bicycle as form, bicycle as a mode of transportation or a social agent. And, you know, in the history of art, and also a lot of contemporary artists are interested in this. And also, I think there's a really strong interest from within the bicycle community. There's a strong interest in design and aesthetics. So those two things really just set the stage for us to ideally bring a lot of different groups together around this exhibition. So we made a choice from the beginning to not exhibit any actual bicycles in this show. We just knew that we couldn't do that well. This isn't really about the engineering of the bicycle or the bicycle form itself. It's more about all the stuff surrounding it, the use of bicycles as a form in a particular artist's work or as subject matter for a documentary, and the history of bicycling, so that we have a number of projects in the exhibition that deal with the history, the current moment, and the future of bicycling, specifically in Rochester.
Well, Cordell, I want to tie you into this. Art, obviously a major focal point, and you're well known for your paintings of people, and,
right.
and the people, oh, I love them.
They
always look like they're having a great time. I want to be them.
I hope so.
And also the scenes, and particular scenes in your work. So how would you explain the merging of art and bicycles as an art form with the work that you're doing for this exhibit?
Well, I kind of bring the aesthetic, I suppose, like you, Bleu was talking about, to the show. My paintings are depicting people riding bicycles and having fun, like you said. And so I'm just trying to have, we were trying to have fun with it, and there's an animation called The Triplets of Belleville, and I was kind of working off of that show to capture just having fun riding bikes and you know, yeah.
Well, Scott, as we've learned, Ride It encompasses a variety of things, and bike culture and bike advocacy is also a part of this exhibit. So I'm sure people are wondering, what is bike culture? So how would you explain that first? What is bike culture in Rochester?
Well, I'm from Portland, Oregon, and their bike culture is really big. They have a whole month of just all sorts of bike festivals, essentially, and it's really evolved. And so what we've found is that the successful cities that develop biking, those are the cities that attract millennials, the best and the brightest. Young people want to bike and walk. They want to be in a bike walk friendly environment, and so mayors are competing all over the country for that. One of the things that we learned in Portland basically was that you have to develop the bike culture as well, and what Bleu and Cordell are doing are helping to kind of develop that joy that we get from bicycling, and that feeling of freedom. You know, if you go back when you were a kid, you know, that being able to ride your bike was one of the great feelings of freedom and enjoyment that we all had, and it's a very emotional thing. And the beauty of the art that we see evokes that type of thing too. So the combination is kind of magical.
So talk about how bike culture makes its way into this exhibit.
Well, bicyclists have always been interested in bike art, and we're actually very thirsty for it. And Bleu came up with this great idea of sort of combining bike art with the biking community, because it is growing very significantly over the past few years. You want to talk a little bit about it?
Yeah. Well, what I think what's unique about this project is we've tried to both include artists who are doing representational artworks that have to do with bicycling and bike culture, but we also tried to engage with a number of organizations who can kind of round out the conversation. The Genesee Center for the Arts does this really cool project every year called Spokes in Ink, which engages with a lot of graphic artists, and they make all these bike-related posters. So we kind of did a best of that in our exhibition. And then both the U of R Rare Books and Special Collections Library and the local history division of the public library each created these really fascinating exhibits, small displays about the history of bicycling in Rochester. Very, you know, kind of little known stories about the early context of bicycling. At one time, Rochester was known as the bicycling center in the country.
I mean, we had Side Path magazine, a national magazine. Yeah. Exactly. In the late 1890s, early 1900s, I learned about that.
Yeah. So we try to bring together a documentary element, a fine art element, historical context, film and video, to kind of round out the conversation, hopefully bringing these different communities, these different parts of bike culture in Rochester, all together in one space. The Contemporary Art Center is not a bike organization per se, but we're interested in this topic for this time, and we can hopefully create some new conversations.
Cordell, I have to ask you, are you a cyclist? Do you bike?
I do bike. So yes.
So how did you approach your work? I mean, in terms of the work that you did for this exhibit, how did you approach it?
I tried to look historically, like looking at how the bike developed through time, and that's kind of that's where I went with it. I picked different bikes, you know, through different eras, and so that's how I approached it.
Well, exciting exhibit to see, and I look forward to checking it out myself. And Cordell Cordaro, Dr. Scott MacCrae, Bleu Cease, thank you so much for your time. And you can learn more about Ride It, Art and Bicycles in Rochester, opening this weekend at RoCo, running through May 15th. Just go to rochestercontemporary.org.